the Duke of Westminster's Award 2015.
Hello, my name is Archie Edmonds from the Duke of York's Women's School CCF contingent.
Hello, I'm Rebecca Dewhurst from Ear Company Durham ACF.
Hi, I'm Flight Sergeant James Clark from 888 Albury Squadron Air Training Corps.
Hi, I'm Joe Baker from 2nd Northern Ireland Battalion Army Cadet Force.
Hi, I'm Stephen Ishwood from the Isle of Man.
Hello, my name is Charlotte and I'm from Devon Army Cadet Force.
Hello, my name is Oliver Jones and I'm from Cheshire Army Cadet Force.
Hello, my name's Amy Broomhead and I'm from the Reed School CCF.
Hi, I'm Matt Hughes from AV Company Royal Marine Cadets.
Oh, I'd be over the moon if I got to go to South Africa. Like, it would be a dream come true because I think it looks like a fantastic country. And it wouldn't just be like looking at the scenery, I think it'd be a great cultural experience as well, like getting to see how people live across there. And it would be a fantastic trip with other age cadets as well, because obviously you've worked hard to get there, but so have they, so it would be a great like team trip as well. Yeah, it'd be great, just like more bonding than that, so it'd be fantastic.
I think it would open up kind of the whole world by going somewhere really new, somewhere like a whole new continent, something completely different. Climate, new people, seeing totally different things. I don't know, it opened my eyes to other people, not just myself.
I think it would be very rewarding. It will help me look at how far I've developed and how far I've come throughout the course. It will allow me to look at others and learn from others as well.
Gives me butterflies a little bit, because like, I don't think until I've actually come here I haven't actually really thought about the fact that I might be going to Africa, and that's so cool. Like, my friends are quite jealous. Being out there and the experiences you'll have are just going to be experiences you'd never ever get to have like at home or anything, and I think you probably learn a lot. And like, almost like, I've only ever been to the zoo and seen an elephant, but to see an elephant like properly in its natural like habitat and stuff like that, it would be great.
Soaking up the country, seeing what the culture's like, and then obviously seeing some of the wildlife as well, being it's just so different to this country. Going on to the wider world, being able to say I've been to South Africa, I've got a level 3 in something that not a lot of people have in, that'll just help me immeasurably, I think.
The whole trip would be obviously a fit once in a lifetime experience. It would be absolutely amazing to show cadets back at my detachment, at my unit, what it's like, and this is the sort of stuff you can do later on, and all the community stuff that you do there, interact with the local people and obviously have an amazing time and share many amazing memories with all those people in there.
Being able to say that you've come in the top 9 in such a competition and being able to go to South Africa with that, I think it's a great achievement.
Really exciting, actually. It's crazy that such like something like a BTEC can give you this opportunity. So I think it'll make me more humble, especially going and seeing all the disadvantaged people, because I've come from a very sort of advantaged background, let's say, and then seeing people in more disadvantaged backgrounds will make me more humble, and I think it'll make me appreciate what I've got and the opportunity I've been given to go and help them as well.
Like, really proud that I've got this far. And it'd be awesome if we were in South Africa. It'd be great. I've not really been abroad recently, so it'd be a great holiday, effectively. It means that you're not just like an academic person, doesn't it? It like adds character to you and something that you can refer back to and like you have to tell stories to people.